Like, I remember, like, through the first lockdown, it felt like the most agonizingly long thing in the whole wide world. But now it's crazy to think that, like, it's been 2 years. Like, I'm like, whoa, like, that's wild.
It's strange. Like, the last thing that I did, the last like any fun that I really had at like an event was like, I'm a little bit of a club rat. You wouldn't know because you're too young to club. And I went to Rec Room, I went to Rebel, and I was at Kensington for my birthday weekend. And that was the end of 2019. And it's coming up 2 years since I've done anything. I haven't gone to any of the great restaurants in Toronto. I haven't even seen small bands. And it just like, even sometimes I'll be walking down the street in downtown Toronto and I get that nostalgia for how things used to be. It's great that we're starting to get back to a point where we can all come together and start doing things again. But I don't know when we'll be able to go back to a full venue. I don't know when we'll be able to go back to going to Budweiser Stadium or Scotiabank. Like, these are things I'm really, really missing.
Yeah, especially as a musician, it's definitely conversations I've had with my team, like, because it's looking like it's going to kind of be every artist and their team gets to make their own rules, like, obviously with following regulations, but like in terms of what you want from your fans to do, like, so because like I already know there's been the big thing recently is like some restaurants in Toronto are refusing to host if you don't have your vaccine, like they're not taking people who decide not to get vaccinated. And so you have to kind of as an artist decide what are you going to do moving forward, like when things open up, what are your regulations going to be? And no matter what you do, it's going to make some people happy and some people upset. And that's just the unfortunate thing of this industry is that you will not please anyone ever. It's just not humanly possible. Like no matter what I do, someone's going to be happy, someone's going to be upset. So we've been talking a lot about like, so how do we do a live show? You know, how would you space people out? How would you regulate who's vaccinated, who's not? Like, what are the options? And so I've also been looking a lot about like how what they're doing in the US and also what like touring artists are thinking of doing to try and get some insight because it's a lot to think about and it's very stressful to try and figure out how, because I love to perform. I'm a live performer till the day I die. I love to perform. I love meeting people and getting to connect with people in real time. So it's a big thing for me. I'm trying to think how can I make this work, especially because Canada's not nice weather all year round. So at some point, people got to get inside. Like it's already August, right? Like, you know, before you know it, it's going to be cold. People are not going to be happy about standing outside. So it's definitely a lot to think about.
Do you have any dream venues that you would like to play at some point in your career?
Definitely the Rogers Centre. That, I mean, I think they're actually tearing it down now. They might be tearing it down, which would be a little upsetting. But I used to live right beside it in my old apartment. And I would hear all the crowds and I would usually hear whoever was playing. And I remember like, especially going to high school and like having all that around me, I was always just like, oh my God, I wish I could play there. Like that would be incredible. Cause also to sell out a stadium like that or get even close to it, like that's an accomplishment in itself. So like the Rogers Centre would just be a very kind of everything would come full circle if I ever got to do that. That would be awesome.
Nice. Any like smaller Toronto venues that you would like to perform, even if it's like maybe just showing up on stage with a local act even?
Yeah, so that's kind of I love those performances. Like one of my favorite things to watch on YouTube is like you'll see when artists just kind of show up at little venues and they just do little performances. Like I always love that kind of crowd because I also think it's way more interesting to see an artist when they're not like in the full 50,000, like when you can actually kind of see them like right up in your face kind of thing. I think it's called the Velvet. Velvet has really cool atmosphere. I'd love to play there. Like I said, Danforth Music Hall would be really cool. I'm really open to just about any small venue. I actually prefer small venues to huge venues because you can get a little more intimate and have a bit more fun with your audience. So honestly, any small venue would be a dream to me.
Rebel is one of the venues that I would love to play one day. I've gone clubbing at Rebel so many times and have passed out drunk at Rebel so many times, but it's still such a great place. And I've seen DJ acts, I've seen rock bands play there, I've seen pop acts play there. Toronto has a lot of amazing venues, and what the city has been doing and how we've been developing such historical places, I can't wait for all of these new artists that have been building up during this downtime to be unleashed and to really put their mark on these places. It's going to be incredible. And yeah. I definitely see you being amongst that wave.
I really hope so. We're trying.